Hey guys, Samsung came out with the Samsung Galaxy S5 recently, and you say you have the Samsung Galaxy Note 3 with you, and you want to try something new. You want to try the latest from Samsung. That's the UI on the Samsung Galaxy S5. So the developers over at the XDA Developers Forum have come out with a port, the complete port of the Galaxy S5 ROM for the SMN9005, that is the 4G variant of the Galaxy Note 3. So in this video, I'm going to show you guys how to flash the ported version of the Galaxy S5 ROM onto your Galaxy Note 3. So let's get started. First of all, go to settings and check whether your model number is SMN9005. Then hit the power button, restart and reboot into recovery. If you have that option enabled, or else just power off. Then wait for it to power off completely. Okay, it's still powering off. Wait for a bit and should be done anytime soon. And it's done. So now hold the up volume, power and home button at the same time. Once you see recovery booting on top, let go of the keys. So now you'll be reverted to clockward mod recovery. From here you can install the ROM. So you can proceed the instructions as I say. First go to wipe data / factory reset. Yes. And wait for it to complete. I have quite a lot of apps, that's why it's taking some time. Will format your data, cache, system, all kinds of stuff. So give it just 1 or 2 minutes. Okay, it's now checking the external SD card. Now mounting and checking. Okay, that's done. So you see wipe data complete over there. Now again head on over to wipe cache partition. Yes, wipe cache. That's done. Go to advanced, wipe dynamic cache, yes. Then again go back and go to mounts and storage and format system. Then go back, install SIP. Choose it from your SD card, that's the internal storage or external storage if you put it there. I have it in my external storage, so select external SD and select the ROM, that is Galaxy S5 SEMI N9005.zip, and press yes install. So give it around 5 to 10 minutes for it to install. I'll be back once this is done. Okay, as you can see, the download is now complete. and you will get this message, install from SD card complete. Now go back and hit reboot system now. So you will see this message. You get this message when you install a custom ROM. Just ignore the message and give it some time to boot. So as you can see, you see the brand new Samsung Galaxy S5 boot logo. So this ROM has all the features of the Galaxy S5. One of the main disadvantages is the camera is not working. Apart from that, most of the features are working according to the developer. The camera won't work even with using external camera app from the Google Play Store according to the developer. But hopefully he will be able to fix this very soon. And from what I have seen from the XDA forums, this ROM has the complete look of the Galaxy S5. This is totally ported from the Galaxy S5. So this has all the features of it, including the ultra power saving mode. So let's just give the phone a few minutes to boot up. He has told in the forum that it will take some time for it to boot. So let's just wait for a few minutes. So as you can see, we have got a welcome screen here. Preparing device for first time use. This may take up to 3 to 4 minutes. All right, let's wait and see. So as you can see, we are up here and in process, and Samsung account skip. Let me quickly input that. And finish. As you can see, we get the S5 water resistant message, and here we have the brand new Galaxy S5 interface running on the Galaxy Note 3. So as you can see, My Magazine is also there. It seems to be working. Let's try it out. Agree, start, and here you go. My Magazine is also working, and as you can see, this is the new app drawer by Samsung on used on the Samsung Galaxy S5 and the new settings panel. Let's check whether the fingerprint option is there. Yeah, the fingerprint scanner is there, even though the Note 3 doesn't have the fingerprint scanner. The option is there because this is ported from the Galaxy S5 directly. So as you can see, let's go to about device. Let's check where about device is. About device is nowhere to be found, but let's see. Settings, general, about device. So as you can see, this changes the model number of the device to SMG900P, which is the Galaxy S5's model number, but as you can see, this is the Samsung Galaxy Note 3. So and it is running Android 4.4.2 KitKat. So that's that. So let's check out some more features. So let's open the camera and see. Is okay, camera failed, so camera is not working as the developer said. Let's check out the phone. This is the new dial app by Samsung, and contacts, messages, and he is the internet browser. And as you can see, we have the new interface for the folders as well. You can change the color of the folder here like that. And let's check whether OK Google command works. OK Google. As you can see, OK Google also works with this ROM. So let's give it a try. OK Google. What's the time now? Alright, so that's working. So as you can see, the new notification drawer is also available. And let's check the home screen settings. So you can see you have the magazine and you can select this. Let's check out the lock screen on this device. So you can see we have the new lock screen also enabled. So if you have a Samsung Galaxy Note 3 SM N9005, you can follow this tutorial and install the Galaxy S5 ported Galaxy S5 ROM onto your device and experience the latest from Samsung. Even the only drawback to this so far is the camera not working, but hopefully the developer will come out with a fix for this. So we will have to wait and see how it goes. So you can give this a try. That's it for me in this video. So if you flash the ROM successfully, you will have the Samsung Galaxy S5's UI running on your Samsung Galaxy Note 3. So if you like the video and if you appreciate the video, don't forget to hit the like button and the subscribe button link down below. And you can check the download links in the description box below. And you can find me on Facebook, Twitter and Google Plus at Bhanu Athulia. And you can find AndroDollar on Facebook, Twitter and Google Plus at AndroDollar. So you can stay tuned to AndroDollar.com as I will be coming up with a comparison between this and the Galaxy S5, maybe a speed difference or maybe when the developer fixes the camera issue where the camera doesn't work, if the camera doesn't work right now. So if the developer comes out with a fix for that, I will definitely make an update for this video. So you can check out AndroDollar.com for the latest news from tech every day. So stay tuned to AndroDollar.com and you guys have a great day. Take care.